Hello and welcome back dear friends, it's me Odo, and we are back in our campaign of EU4 with Sweden. We are currently trying to get rid of the Livonian Order. Some rest for our fleet. Nah. What do we want? We have 98% war score. That's good. We want these two. We want humiliate, probably. We want war reps, and we want all your money. Yeah, we can't get that more anyway, so let's do it like that. Yeah, that's good. Fine. Okay, we got some prestige. Yay. Go there and stay there, black flagged. So, first of all, let's repay. Nah. Let's repay this loan. Next of all, let's make. Why can't we make a call? Because we don't have the money for it, the admin points for it. Yeah, of course. Stupid. I mean, who needs admin points? But now we have a bigger power projection. Yay! So we gain more of these points. And we should focus on admin now, as we are behind tech and as we are doing this course. Danish devils. Enforced sound tool. Trade power minus 10. Okay. These Danish devils. Ha. Can we go to war with you? Yep, but we would break a truce. But you have no friends. That's great. Then let's go to Viborg. That's better. Let's try to get Neva in Ingermanland. So now we have humiliated a rival, so this goes up faster. We also need a large city. We will do this probably in Stockholm to get the what's it called? Institution, because it takes some time. We have only 0.08 per month. But if we develop this land, then we probably will get it faster. Yeah, of course we will get it faster. You're totally pissed off. Nobles, I know. But this will go away sooner or later. Probably later than sooner. So when will the truces expire? Only in 1 year with Novgorod. That's great. So let's see. Let's revoke this embargo. Where do we have these guys? Ugh. Norman Blackinger. This will go away eventually. Because we get rid of the overextension, but these two don't go away. So let's split the army in two. You go there, and the other guy. More expensive because of my war exhaustion. So we should wait anyway. On the other hand, if we wait, it takes longer to get rid of the overextension, so yeah, let's do it like this. Ships can we have? One more. So you get another ship. Okay, then Let's improve relations with you. Nah. Let's not. Let's just spy on you. So we are making some money, yay! I'm not sure if I want to attack Novgorod at once. We are most probably stronger than him. Where does he have his? Here is his castle. We just need to. Oh, there is another one. What? Wait. Oh, that's not Novgorod. His capital fort is here. Ugh. Somewhere in the vicinity of nowhere. That's great. Okay. We should rival Denmark. Immoral price. Grain prices are notoriously unstable. Anything from the weather where it is grown to incidents hurting its distribution can suddenly cause the price to rise significantly. As a result of one such sudden change, there is currently an acute shortage of grain in many of our larger cities. Desperate to feed themselves, the common people are directing their anger at the merchants who they feel are making good use of this situation to overcharge for their wares. The merchants themselves, on the other hand, claim that this is a natural result of the shortage and that there simply isn't enough bread to go around. So we could force the merchants to lower the prices, which would be bad because the burghers would be mad. We should not meddle in these things. We could help the peasants to rise. We must pay for and distribute what bread there is. Okay. That's interesting. We should go with this because if I see this correctly, nah, they are not. They have to be above 60. I thought they would be above 60. I could have done a lot of development. We have a high income. But we do not do constructions now. Or at least not a lot. So let's see. Arrivals. Novgorod has 8,000 troops. Good. We're stronger than him. He doesn't have any manpower. So there are some peasant rebels in his land that are causing some problems to him. Forward to glory, morale of armies plus 10%, yearly army tradition plus 1, yearly prestige plus 0.5 for 20 years. This costs us money, admin power and splendor. Whatever splendor is. Yeah, why not? They know that I want to do war on him because they just built their own. Really? More loyalty of the burghers. Now the burghers are loyal, aren't they? Yep. So what we could do is we could wait for 1 month with this update. Then do some development in Stockholm. Yeah, I know, I have loans. Go away. So it's only 44, and if we... it takes some time for the prosperity. If we encourage development, it's even 39, down to 39. So let's see. 83%. Yay. Also, we have the large city. Ah, this is splendor. Yeah, that's okay. If we can stay at 30 points. 30 points are 10 months. Now it's not even 20 months because we now gain. Another objective, so it's 5 we gain. No, we gain 3. Interesting. I thought it's 2 per objective that we got. Whatever. Let's do the war with Novgorod before Russia or Muscovy. Starts to do something stupid. Let's take this claim. going to Omega. So like there. Another infertile king. Sure, probably this was the game I was not going on. Happiness among artisans, stability -1, or let's pay some more gold. Yeah, okay. I mean, Novgorod is hopefully rather rich. So normally should be able to get something out of that. Troops left, so we killed him. This was much easier than the war against the Livonian Order. Yeah, okay, let's accept that. Oh, we have positive prestige. This is interesting. Can't remember when this was last time. At the start of the game. So we want these two because they are the ones that we need. Also, we want all your money and four reps. sure if we want... like this. Because we really need some... false religion. No, he's too big. Let's just wait until we have his last city. Separatists are nearly gone. How about these two? Nearly done as well. Stop. Ach, so stupid. That's great. So, okay. Stockholm. Just waiting. Let's wait at speed 5. Come over France is the new papal controller. It's January. Those troops here. That's not nice. Let's take this city. Yay. Okay. So now we have a 100% deal. So we can do this. Aggressive expansion, that's okay. Fine, okay, okay. So now we can go everywhere in our country. Scotland wants an alliance. Do we want an alliance with Scotland? I'm not sure. I mean, we have still the royal marriage with him. And he's rival to Denmark and Brittany. And he intrudes with England. Well, let's see. Okay, dear friends, this is what I did today. I won't do anything more because I'm tired. So, everyone, let's go to bed. I hope you enjoyed it. Yep. Good night and sleep well. Until then, bye.